Hi, I'm Matt. In today's Epiphan U video, we're going to be talking about our new integration with Panopto. Let me show you how it's done. The first thing you're going to want to do is log into Panopto. Once you've logged into Panopto, you'll be able to drop down to Systems, Remote Recorders, and to add your device, you're going to need the host information and a registration key. So you're going to click on Manage Registration Keys and create a new registration key. Once a new registration key has been created, the registration key will appear below. From there, you'll be able to go into the web user interface, scroll down to the configuration section, and simply click on the CMS page. From there, ensure that you've selected Panopto and add all of the information that's required. First, you're going to need your URL. And a registration key. If you'd like to assign a specific name for it, you can. You can also adjust the scheduling features for Epiphan U. As an example, if you wanted multiple users to be able to utilize your device, simply add the extension of the email address required. Under Event Owners would be the default name that appears on the touchscreen of Pearl Mini or Pearl 2 when getting ready to log in. Once you're all set, click Apply, and it'll register your device. Once the device is registered, you'll see Connect at the top. The last step when configuring your Pearl Mini or Pearl 2 is to manage your remote recorder. Under the Remote Recorder section, so again, under Systems and Remote Recorder, you'll be able to find all devices that are currently registered with Panopto. For example, here we have the Pearl Mini we just registered. If we highlight the device, you'll notice that I have previews to see my channels here, and under the section called Configuration, I can select my primary and secondary video and audio sources. You'll notice that I have two configured channels within Pearl Mini. However, if you have something like Pearl 2, where you may have more encoded channels, you can specify and select which channels you would like to be utilizing. As an example, if I only want to use one channel, I can unselect HDMI-B, and only HDMI-A channel will be the one used with Panopto. Below, you'll see some quality settings. Now, it's important to note that whatever quality settings you set here on Panopto will also reflect in Pearl Mini or Pearl 2 for the recordings. For Pearl Mini specifically, if you have it set to 1920 by 1080 at 60 frames per second, Pearl Mini will understand that and only support its 30 FPS as it was designed to. For my secondary video source, I may want to adjust that as well because I'm only seeing 1280 by 1024 at 4 frames per second. So I will adjust that accordingly. Once I'm happy with everything that I see, I can simply close the checkbox and we're set to go. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos on how you can make your Pearl Mini or Pearl 2 work with the content management system.